The next system we're going to talk about is the circulatory system, and there's three parts to this system: the blood, the blood vessels, and the heart. So first, if we look at the blood, it has four main components. It's got the plasma, the white blood cells, the platelets, and the red blood cells. The plasma is the fluid that carries various blood cells around, as well as various dissolved nutrients and wastes. So all these other kinds of cells, the platelets, will all be carried, as well as dissolved nutrients. So glucose, amino acids, nitrogen wastes, all of that will be dissolved in the plasma. White blood cells are a key part of the immune system, and we'll spend more time talking about those when we get to the immune system. Platelets are fibers that cause clotting. This is also going to be part of the immune system, help speed immune response, and create scabs to protect and heal damage. What we're going to focus on here more are the red blood cells, and these are the blood cells specifically designed to carry oxygen molecules. So here's what healthy red blood cells look like. They contain hemoglobin proteins. This is a protein that is folded in a specific way. It holds an iron atom, and it's able to pick up oxygen at very high concentrations, but let go of it at very low concentrations. So when red blood cells are in the lungs, they're going to pick up oxygen, and then when they get out to the cells in the capillary beds, they'll release their oxygen. They're sort of unique in our bodies. They're eukaryotic cells, they're part of humans, but they actually don't have a nucleus. They don't have the ability to make their own proteins. They're basically just designed entirely to carry oxygen and release it and not do anything else. They have a relatively short lifespan. They can't produce other enzymes they need to maintain the cell for longer. So they live 80 to 120 days. And that means that you're constantly producing more and more red blood cells. And that's done by specialized stem cells in your bone marrow. How many red blood cells you should be making is triggered by a hormone produced in the kidneys, and that is a negative feedback loop based on oxygen level in the cells. So if oxygen levels are starting to get low inside cells, the kidney will produce this hormone. It will cause the bone marrow to create more red blood cells, which will deliver more oxygen, and oxygen levels should go up in the cells. The next part of the system I want to talk about are the blood vessels. And the blood vessels are a closed system of tubes that carry blood throughout the body. There's three main kinds of blood vessels. There are arteries, veins, and capillaries. Arteries are blood vessels that take blood away from the heart. Veins are blood vessels that take blood back to the heart. And capillaries are where arteries and veins meet. Typically, textbooks will depict red blood as blood that's containing oxygen and blue as deoxygenated blood. So here, these are arteries. They're leaving the heart. They're taking blood away from the heart. They're branching into smaller and smaller bits till we get the capillaries. The blood in the capillaries is going to drop off its oxygen. It's going to leave, pool back into venules and then into veins, and it's now deoxygenated blood. So the capillaries are where gas exchange is going to happen between the circulatory system and individual tissues. It's also where nutrients will be exchanged, wastes, hormones, anything that the circulatory system is delivering, it's going to deliver at the point of the capillaries. The capillaries are very, very thin and very numerous, and this just allows a lot of surface area for diffusion. We can move lots of materials back and forth if we have more surface area. I want to mention just a few specific blood vessel systems. These are regions that deliver and take away blood from a particular organ or set of organs. The pulmonary system are the system of arteries and veins that deliver blood to and from the lungs. And this is the connection, obviously, between the circulatory and respiratory system. The coronary system is the system of arteries and veins that deliver blood to and from the heart muscle. Now, this is completely different from the blood that's moving through the heart. We'll talk about that in a minute, but this is the blood that's going to the actual heart muscle surrounding the chambers, and it's providing oxygen so that the heart muscle can make ATP and continue to pump. So obviously this is a very, very important blood system. So for some of you, a coronary might sound familiar. Doctors sometimes refer to a heart attack as a coronary, and the reason for that is a heart attack is when the coronary system isn't working properly. For some some reason, usually because of some kind of blockage in the arteries or veins, oxygen is not getting to a particular bit of cardiac muscle tissue. As that tissue begins to die because it's not getting enough oxygen and not making enough ATP, then you will experience what we think of as a heart attack. A mild heart attack is a small blockage with just a little bit of tissue death. A massive heart attack is when a larger area of tissue dies. You can get the same kind of blockage to the blood in the brain, and that is what we call a stroke. And again, you can have a minor or a major one. Now, you can get blockages in blood vessel systems anywhere in the body. You can get it in your calf or in your hand. In those areas, it will be physically painful, but the blood getting to those tissues is not as essential as the blood getting to your heart or your brain. And unfortunately, blockages to those places can be very debilitating or even deadly. Finally, the last part of the system is the heart. And this is the pump that keeps blood moving through the veins and arteries. The heart has four chambers, two atriums. The atria are the chambers that receive blood. They have thinner walls, and remember, if they're receiving blood, they must be coming from veins. So we have the left atrium and the right atrium. Then we have two ventricles, and these are the muscular chambers that actually pump the blood. And if you look at the picture here, this shows the muscle around the chambers of the heart. And notice that the muscle is much thicker around the ventricles than it is around the atria. These guys are receiving blood. They don't need to be as strong, where this lower area is going to contract and pump blood through the body. In between our different chambers, we have our four chambers, we have valves, and these white areas indicate the valves. And these valves open and close to make sure the blood is moving the correct direction through the heart. So if we sort of follow how blood moves through here, blood is going to come back from the body into the right atrium. And it's going to come in from this vein and drop into the right atrium. From here, it's going to go right atrium and then down into the right ventricle. And notice we're using the blue color here to depict deoxygenated blood. It's coming back from the body. The body has used up the oxygen. It's got lots of carbon dioxide. Now this right ventricle is going to squeeze. And when it squeezes, the blood is going to move up through this tube, this artery, and notice it says pulmonary. That tells you it's heading towards the lungs. If you didn't have these valves, when this ventricle squeezed, some of the blood would go this way, but some would go back the wrong direction. And so this valve is going to open, blood will drop down, this will squeeze, this will close, this will open, and the blood can move up through. So it's a carefully timed dance between the valves when they open and close. Now if we go to the left side of the heart, the blood is now oxygenated. It's coming back from the lungs, right lung and left lung, and it's going to drop into the left atrium. From the left atrium, it will drop down into the left ventricle, and now this is going to squeeze. And from this left ventricle, the blood is going to be pumped throughout your entire body. So the squeezing here is going to have to pump blood to the brain and down to the tip of your toes. So this is probably the most powerful piece of the heartbeat. Again, you have valves that are working in a coordinated way. So when you hear a heartbeat, the bump, 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 what you're actually hearing is the different valves slapping open and closed. Sometimes you'll hear about someone having a heart murmur. What that means is that there's a little leak when one of these valves is closed, and a little bit of blood seeps through one direction or the other, and to the doctor, it sounds like a little hissing sound. Sometimes kids are born with heart murmurs, and they sort of grow into their valves. Other times, you actually have to get valve replacements when these fail. They can use plastic, or sometimes they use pig heart valves, which are formed similar to ours, to replace those so that you efficiently move blood in the right direction. I'm going to show this video here online. You can also watch it on your own. It's a great illustration of what the different chambers of the heart look like, the different arteries and veins that are coming in, and especially how coordinated those different valves are. And you can hear from it where your heartbeat comes from. One of the things I always like to remind people as we look at this, it's hard to design a car that lasts for a long time, a computer, some piece of equipment. This is an amazing piece of machinery that just works, beats just like this for 85, 95 years straight. So it's a pretty amazing piece of equipment that we have running our circulatory system. So as blood flows through the circulatory system, it takes about a minute for a bit of blood to make it all the way through the system from the heart and back. The greatest pressure is right in the aorta as the blood is leaving the heart, and the lowest pressure is in the veins just because it's really far away from that original pump. So this is a really nice graphic to review what's going on the overall circuit of blood as it moves through your body. Notice this is all a closed loop. The arteries are taking blood away from the heart, veins are bringing it back. So if we start in the heart here, we have a couple veins bringing blood back into the right atria, down into the right ventricle will pump and send blood to both of the lungs. In the lungs, it's going to drop off carbon dioxide, pick up oxygen, and come back to the heart on both sides. That drops into the left atrium, down into the left ventricle, and a really strong pump here comes out of the heart and goes to the capillaries in the upper part of the body and capillaries in the mid and lower part of the body, then gets pumped back into the veins and comes back to the heart. So this video gives you a brief review of those major parts of the circulatory system and how they work together.